Hello and welcome. It's myself, Jamie of GEOSynths, and I'm back today with, well, I'm starting a series of videos of top 10 tips of sound design, things that I utilize in every patch I make, whether it's to do with the oscillator section, envelopes, filters. It's really about the process that I use. So when it comes to sound design, what's your process? How do you start? I mean, do you just turn it on? Get a sound that's similar to what you have in mind, whether it's a pad, strings, lead or whatever, and then just tweak it and tailor it? Or do you just get a sound and randomly change knobs and see what the results are? Now, neither of those approaches are wrong, but what I do is a process, and I do it pretty much for all the sounds I make. There's a couple of times when I have to do things slightly different. However, I do have a process, and I know what it's like. It's so easy just to turn up a saw wave or whatever and then jump straight for the cutoff knob and go, because it's the knob that it should be called change everything so drastically knob rather than the cutoff knob. Somehow I don't think it will fit. So one day you might think, you know what, I fancy having a go at doing something from scratch. You know, you fired up your DAW and it's just a blank screen looking at you. They're actually the good times to start making sounds, actually, when you're not in that kind of musical creative mood, but you still want to do something to do with synths. Okay, so the first thing you need to do is turn your phone off. Of course, if you're watching this video, then, well, I don't know, but turn your phone off. You don't want distractions. Shut down your emails. No distractions. It's just you, the synth, and remember, it's for fun. It's supposed to be a fun moment, fun time. You shouldn't be putting pressure on yourself saying, oh, it's got to be good or I'm rubbish or and that kind of thing. There's no wrong with making sound design because they're your sounds. So as you can see, I'm here with the Prophet 12. No particular reason other than I'm making patches for it at the moment. However, it does have a very good oscillator section. In fact, there's four of them. And lots of tools and things to mess about with. So whatever synth you're using, you may not have as much as this. However, pretty much all synthesizers that are in this kind of subtractive category pretty much all work the same. So I wonder if this is familiar. Start off with a sawtooth. Add a second one. Bit of detune. Over to the cutoff and a bit of resonance. Is that it? Yeah, we're not going to do things that way. So we're going to start with oscillator one. Now, of course, you've got your main wave shapes. So for instance, this is sawtooth, square or pulse, triangle, and sine. And they're your kind of usual suspects. Different synthesizers will have different types of shapes on there as well, like. Obviously, this is digital. But what I want you to do is kind of think of those shapes as like colours, really. They're the primary colours, red, blue, green. And what we're after is the shades of those colours, the colours that you can create in between. As well as the wave shape, we've got the ability to modulate that shape, which will change the timbre, the tone of the sound. Also have volume and the pitch, so we can control those either manually, or we can use modulation to do that. But we won't get onto that just yet. What I want you to do is just hear the changes of those oscillators. So just with one oscillator. So we've got those main colours. Now, let's change the timbre a little. So that is changing the timbre of it. So it's like almost to a degree that you're EQing the sound, EQing that tone. Let's make it even more obvious by choosing a pulse or a square. So this has got lots of harmonics. However, when we change the modulation, course, that's pulse width modulation. We all know that. You modulate it to get that kind of tone. However, you listen to that, you might think, yeah, I'm not really going to use that. It sounds horrible. All the mids gone, all the low ends gone. So it's very high mids, very high. Low frequencies have gone out of that. So you might, well, all I can do is make a clav sound out of that. However, we're now going to utilize Oscillator 2. Now, this is probably one thing you might not do all the time. Is you go to Oscillator 2, bring it up, turn down Oscillator 1 to nothing. Because you just want to listen to the oscillator. Oscillator 2 in this case. Now, we've already got a kind of brightness with Oscillator 1. So why don't we choose a wave that's got more lower mids, low frequencies. So we've got a triangle. So there's a bit there of buzz, bit of low end, it's more mid-rangey, but let's change the shape. Tiny bit of buzz there, so 17, but it's still got low mids and low. So let's just blend in now Oscillator 1. And you hear what's happening there is, by using the volume between those two oscillators, we're creating a new total wave shape. So we have the ability now, because that's over two oscillators, to modulate them separately if we want to. Then we could do the usual with a bit of detune there. And of course, by messing and changing that tone manually, you get yourself a good idea of what it would sound like if you use some LFOs. So a slow LFO. Something a bit quicker. Or maybe an envelope that goes. But of course, you may want to use more oscillators on top of that. Now, depending on the synth that you've got, you may only have two oscillators and a sub-oscillator. What we can do is go to Oscillator 1, turn up the pitch, bring down the volume, and we've now got the sub-oscillator in the same pitch range as Oscillator 2. So if we turn down Oscillator 1, turn down Oscillator 2, just bring up the sub. Now, there's not a huge amount of tone or control really on sub-oscillators, but you can use it just to fill out some frequencies. Oscillator 1. Oscillator 2. And as I said, you can blend them. So what I tend to do when it gets to this point is just play a chord and then just mess with the volumes of all of those oscillators. Hear how that is changing the timbre. So in a way, you're using the oscillators like EQ. You're using the different types of wave shapes as a kind of way of filtering the sound before you even get to the filter. Now, you could have an LFO going to the volume of that, or an envelope, so it'll only do it once. So what I'm going to do now is modulate the oscillators. So we've got the sound. And I'm going to modulate with an LFO, LFO 4, that shape mod of oscillator 1. So I'm going to turn down the volume of oscillator 2 and the sub-oscillator. So we're going to change the shape mod. LFO assigned to that. Set it to a point. Turn the volume down and then start blending in the other oscillators. So I'm going to turn those oscillators down again, but this time I want to hear just oscillator 2. So I kind of like the shape of that, and I like the tone of that. So again, it's going to be a different LFO to that. This time it's a little quicker. So we've got those three oscillators. I'm going to turn down all of them. Start with oscillator. Well, actually, I will start with the sub. I'm going to bring in oscillator 2. And we're just blending them now like we would as if we were EQing a complete sound. To me, the sine wave, which is the sub, is a little bit too loud. I want that triangle wave to be the main focus of the sound, the complete wave shape. Now, oscillator 1, which won't take much. And we can then again check any detuning that we need to do. So I've got -6 for oscillator 2. I'm going to go +5 or 6 for oscillator 1. And sub oscillator is not much I can do about that. On the synth, you've got pan spread, so I'm just going to open up the sound a little bit and you can start to hear the tone a little bit better. So hopefully you can hear there that by blending the oscillators together and turning the volumes all the way down and bringing them back up, the idea is to, rather than see those three oscillators as three different things, the ultimate goal is to create one wave shape before it goes into the filter. Now, this wave shape is moving, but it's still a total wave shape. It's got low mids, It's got lows. It's got the highs. Now, of course, this synthesizer has a lot more going for it. We've still got two other oscillators. So I could bring in something else. So what am I listening for there? Well, when I turn that off, if I listen, I'm going through the wave shapes and I'm seeing which jump into their own space or the ones that are reinforcing frequencies that are already here. Now we can start to blend things back in again. So starting with the sub-oscillator. Oscillator 2, which is the main tone. By doing this process, you can start to think to yourself, well, actually, it would sound all right if this oscillator could fade in and out. So you could do that with an LFO or with an envelope. That's something to do later on, really. Oscillator 1. And oscillator 3. Now, the thing to look out for is obviously there's quite a lot of frequencies going on there, and we don't want them to clash too much. So this is where the blending happens. But you still need some frequencies in there for the filter to grab hold of and carve out. So hopefully that was interesting for you. Really, it's just all about taking some time and some patience over the oscillator section and just blend them well and just listen to the in-between areas. And when you turn it and you think, yeah, that sounds a bit weedy and naff, leave it and use another oscillator to fill in those frequencies before going over to things like the envelopes and filter. You might be surprised at what you come up with.